Welcome to Mesquite ISD's Allergy Awareness Training. Definitions you need to be aware of before you can understand this training. Allergy, a potentially serious immune-mediated response to contact with a specific allergen. These can be food, insect, medication, or latex. Food allergy, potentially serious response that develops after ingesting or coming into contact with a specific food or food additive. Anaphylaxis, a serious allergic reaction that is rapid in onset and may cause death. Most common food allergies are milk, eggs, peanuts, tree nuts, shellfish, fish, soy, and wheat. More than 90% of allergic reactions are from these foods. Signs and symptoms include life-threatening reactions that may be caused by the food protein, insect venom such as a bee or wasp or ant sting, a medication, or latex. Onset of symptoms may occur within seconds or up to 2 hours after exposure. In 1/3 of reported reactions, individuals experience what's called a biphasic reaction, where the early phase of the symptoms is followed by a delayed or late phase of symptoms. Signs and symptoms that you may see or experience with a student experiencing anaphylaxis in the mouth, they may complain of tingling, itching, swelling of the tongue, lips. Their mouth may appear blue or gray on the inside as well as the color of their lips. Their throat may become tightened. They may have a tickling feeling in the back of their throat. They may become hoarse or their voice will change entirely. Nose, eyes, and ears become runny, itchy, red, or swelling. Other symptoms include shortness of breath, nausea, vomiting, an itchy rash on their skin. Perhaps they have facial swelling or flushing. Their heart may cause them to have a thin, weak pulse or a rapid pulse. Their face and nail beds will become pale. Beware of potential hazards. Avoid using food for instructional purposes, trail mix, M&M candies, popcorn mixes. Read food labels to identify allergens in the ingredients. Communicate with parents to promote awareness in case of field trips or special group events. In accordance with state guidelines, a food allergy management plan has to be developed for students who have an allergy. Identifying students at risk for anaphylaxis. It implements an emergency care plan, an individualized care plan, and 504 plans for students at risk with anaphylaxis. Reduce the risk of exposure to identify allergens within the school setting. Educate staff on anaphylaxis and emergency response to anaphylaxis reaction. Review policies and procedures after an anaphylactic event. Each campus should have a food allergy management team to assist in the implementation of the plan. Various plans, FAAP, EAP, IHP, 504. A food allergy action plan, emergency action plan, is developed by the student's primary care provider, stating the steps to take in case of exposure or onset of symptoms. An individualized health plan is developed by the school nurse, the RN, to assist the student to identify potential problems and outcomes, establish interventions, and evaluate outcomes. Campus 504 committee consideration is to provide protections from possible discrimination related to the student's allergy. General strategies include discouraging labeling or discussing food allergic students in the presence of others. Encourage at-risk students to totally avoid food allergens. Make wise choices and read labels. Be prepared in case an emergency reaction occurs. Know how to access epinephrine for the student. Adhere to universal precautions to avoid accidental exposure. Increase awareness through staff education as well as classmates and families. Avoid use of food products as displays in hallways and other common areas. Be careful with food preparation and cleanup to avoid cross-contamination. Discourage and report any type of food bullying. To reduce risks and strategies in the classroom, alert substitutes to the presence of a student with an allergy-related plan. Place it in your substitute folder. Conduct non-identifying age-appropriate training on life-threatening allergies for the class. Distribute letters to parents of students enrolled in a class, citing the need to avoid certain foods in the classroom without identifying the affected student. Discourage sharing or trading of food items between students. Avoid use of food items for classroom projects, activities, and monitor items provided for classroom parties. Notify parents of the affected student of classroom events, activities, or celebrations that may involve food. Encourage students to wash their hands with soap and water before and after eating. Sanitizing gels do not remove food allergens from the hands. In the cafeteria, be aware of students with food allergies. Share ingredient lists with students and parents as necessary. Train food service personnel on food label reading and safe handling of food, as well as safe meal substitutions. Cafeteria monitors need to be educated regarding food allergies and the potential for cross-contamination. Designate an allergen-safe dining area for at-risk students. Single-use disposable wipes, such as Clorox wipes, should be used to clean surfaces. Discourage sharing, trading of foods, drinks, straws, or even utensils, and continue to encourage hand washing before and after eating. For bus transportation, be aware of students with food allergies at risk for anaphylaxis. This may mean speaking to the bus driver. Meet with the campus food allergy management team. Consider seating students with food allergies at risk for anaphylaxis near the front of the bus. Discourage eating and sharing food on the bus. Be aware and report any incidents of food bullying. Provide the bus driver and aides with training on symptoms of and response to allergic reactions. Reinforce emergency communication systems in place and plans for the bus driver. For field trips and other events, communicate the food allergy action plan to the staff. Collaborate with the school nurse prior to the event to facilitate the review of emergency procedures and communications, as well as the availability of emergency medications for the event. Select locations that are appropriate for students with food allergies, such as a field trip to a local peanut farm would not be scheduled for a class with a peanut allergic student. Encourage parents of food allergic students to attend field trips, noting that parent attendance is not required for the student to participate. Notify parents if food will be served at the event or on a field trip. When a reaction occurs, remain calm. Follow the physician's instructions on the food allergy action plan. Do not hesitate to administer the student's EpiPen when it's available. Call 911, even if the medication has been administered and the student appears to be improving. Contact the school nurse or in the campus office. Call the parent or guardian. Dispose of the EpiPen in a sharps container using universal precautions or give it to EMS. Epinephrine basics. Epinephrine is the first-line treatment for anaphylaxis. It is prescribed for emergency use as an auto-injector device that is easy to use. Epinephrine auto-injectors should be stored in an unlocked area for ease of access that is secure from other students. When district guidelines are met, students may be allowed to carry their epinephrine on their person during the school day. When epinephrine is administered, 911 should always be called in case the student experiences a biphasic reaction. Six rights to the administration of medication. Is this the right student? Is this the right medication? Am I giving the right dose? Is it the right route? Is it the right time? And am I doing the correct documentation? Whenever epinephrine is given, again, always call 911. How to use an EpiPen. Remove an auto-injector from the carrier tube prior to use. Never put your thumb, fingers, or hand over the orange tip. Never press or push the orange tip with the thumb, fingers, or hand. The needle comes out of the orange tip. Do not remove the blue safety release until you are ready for use. Do not use if the solution is discolored. Do not place patient insert or any other foreign objects into the carrier with the auto injector, as this may prevent you from removing the auto injector for use. Flip open the yellow cap of the EpiPen or the green cap of the EpiPen Junior carrier tube. Tip the tube and slide the EpiPen out. Grasp the unit with the orange tip pointed downward. Form a fist around the unit. Hold the orange tip near the outer thigh. Do not inject into the buttocks. Swing your arm and firmly press at a 90-degree angle against the outer thigh until the unit clicks. The auto-injector is designed to go through clothing. Hold firmly against the thigh for approximately 10 seconds to complete the drug delivery. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, it takes that long. Remove the unit from the thigh, noting that the orange needle cover extends the covered needle. Massage the injection site for 10 seconds. Call 911 to activate EMS. Dispose of the EpiPen in a sharps container or, as stated before, give to the EMS when they arrive. Note that the correct dose is given when the orange needle tip is extended and the window is obscured. Another type of auto-injector is called the AviQ epinephrine pen. It's a small iPod-shaped device. It has audio prompts that provide instructions for use. Pressure-activated needle is deployed without any swinging, just a firm press. The medication is administered within 1 second of needle deployment, and the needle retracts automatically. This device counts down from 5, indicating the injection is complete, and then beeps and flashes a light indicating administration has completed. To use this device, remove the outer case to activate the voice instructions. Pull off the red safety guard. Place black end against the outer thigh. Do not apply the black end to any other part of the body. Press firmly and hold for 5 seconds. Call 911 to activate EMS. Dispose of the device in a sharps container or give it to EMS. Identify as is possible the source of an allergen after an exposure. If a food was served in the cafeteria, it is thought to be the source. Work with food services to reduce future risk. Review all information surrounding the reaction. Take steps to prevent further reaction. Dispel rumors and review administrative guidelines. Review the Food Allergy Action Plan, IEP, and 504 to amend or address any changes made for the student's health care provider. Ask parents to replace school supplies of any emergency medication administered. For more information, check this website. The school nurse will contact you with further information and additional training if you are working with a student at risk for anaphylaxis.